horse people. I've been wanting this thing's tab's been open forever, trying to look at these horses they're walking. So I'm just going to incline to some people say nagging or picking or being mean, but I'm going to pick out things that I kind of look for when I see horses, like their feet, where are they walking. This guy I think is a better horseman because he's on the grass and he's not on the hard pavement. These guys are making their horses walk on hard pavement when there's plenty of ground they could be walking on. To me, a horseman thinks of his horse, and he doesn't want his horse pounding on hard concrete when he could have him on the side. Again, if it's safe, if there's barbed wire over here, it was ditches, if it was a cliff, then I would say walking on a street is okay. But when you have options to make it better for your horse and you choose not to, to me, that's bad horsemanship. Let's see what else we got here. So, as I'm scanning around here, I see people with their phones filming. Really bad for a horse, because you only got one hand, you're not paying attention. You're constantly spinning your shoulders and moving your weight around, which confuses a horse. I see everybody's got these long bits. Man, Canada must have a lot of freaking bad horsemanship. I see all long bits, and these are like gag bits right here. The way this thing pulls back, it gags the bit back into the mouth. So when she pulls on this, the leverage pushes back. You're going to see at the end here, one of the horses got white foam coming out of his mouth from this one knucklehead with his big bit. So I did not see one person riding without a bit. I see a lot of tie downs. I see a lot of things that I'm just kind of like, wow. All right, so let's see. We have bits. We have lots of horses on the road and lots on the grass. I would be on the grass if I was riding here because it's better for the horse. These are different breast collars. This is a breast collar that's lower. I like the one that goes over the shoulder better. That's the one I use. That's why I use it, because I like it better. I think it's called a pulling harness, I think. And if you're pulling backwards or you dally up where you wrap a rope and pull something, when it pulls back, instead of pulling across these shoulders trying to work, it pulls up around a longer area. So it takes more leather. It costs more. But I think it's a better type of a shoulder holster if you're going to be wearing one. Might be like this one's wearing, but I'm not sure. So I'm looking at people's hand movement, whether they're pulling, whether they're tugging, whether they're looking where they're going. Horses, when you look not where you're going, a horse can feel your hips and shoulders. That's why they always tell you, look where you're going and your horse will usually go. You don't even have to tell them. Okay, so I noticed a lot of people have ropes. I carry a rope. I like to have a rope on me for lots of reasons. If I need to, you know, tie up my horse, if I can tie it up between two things and have a place to tie my horse off. If I need to pull a horse or cattle or something gets stuck, I can pull it. If I need to drag something, I can rope it and use my horse to pull it. So having a rope is a nice tool to always have. The proper way to wear this is when you get on your horse, it's underneath your leg. And you always want to pull that rope to where it's on top of your leg. You don't want your weight and everything mashing down on this curb, irritating your horse and giving your horse a rub burn. Again, we got shank bits. See what else. Hang on here. What do we see here? Oh, went too far back. I wanted to go. Crap. Man, I got crazy here. Okay, so I think this horse here with the pink has a tie down. Oh no, that's just like a lead rope. So people that ride with bits will leave their halter on and the lead rope, and they'll have that third rope there. So if they get off, some people call it a get down rope. You can just get down and hold on to your horse and you're not pulling on the reins. It's okay. It's cool. It's traditional. A lot of people do it. But if you're riding a rope halter, you don't need that. You got your reins and your rope, and your horse has only got one thing. When you have this, whatever bridle or headgear you're using is usually on top of that, and then you have double the friction and moving and uncomfortables and wearing the hair off that you would normally have. Let's go through here frame by frame, see what we get here. Okay, hats, gloves, it's obviously cold, jackets. This little horse right here has, I don't like when people don't adjust their gear. This is called a Bozell hanger, and this is because it's so far up, it runs right next to that eye. So the horse is constantly irritating. It affects his eye every time he blinks. Every time you give him a direction to move this, it moves this closer into the eye or off the eye. I don't like things around my horse's eyes, and horses don't like things around their eyes. So, not a fan of that. Rick, you're just picking on everybody. Well, I'm just telling you. Okay, he's got his rope tied up over here. He's got a nice saddle. That looks like a, I can't think of his kind of saddle I have, and I can't even think of it. It's got a large wooden horn for dialing up and pulling. He's got his rope over his leg. That's good. That's over his leg. They got one hand. He's got the split finger. Let's see here. What else we see here? Holy shit, that freaking woman is huge. Is that a woman or a guy? I can't tell how big that horse is, but Jesus Christ, she is large for that horse. So the horse's butt looks pretty big, so maybe it's a pretty good size horse. The saddle looks pretty freaking small. It almost disappears. If you're making your saddle disappear, you might need a bigger saddle. I'm just saying. Rick, why are you picking? I'm just saying. I'm looking at things when I look at horsemanship on people that are taking care. When she is this large and has this small saddle, it puts more pressure and weight on a smaller area on the horse. If she, notice how far back this saddle goes from this guy's back. This is giving more surface area to spread out his weight over a larger surface of the horse's back. Therefore, he doesn't cause pressure points on one area. You don't ride on a 2x4 because if you use a 2x4 for saddle, all your weight is on the weight of one 2x4. So the larger you have area over your saddle, now obviously your saddle pad distributes the weight. Then you have a large leather area distributing the weight over the saddle pad, so you're not making what's called hot spots or pressure points. This saddle is very small, and this saddle is causing pressure points. And she looks like she's got some fluffy, pretty, freaking cute, soft saddle pad instead of a good, thick wool pad. This distributes weight better because it's denser than this soft, frilly, light crap. All right, Rick, why are you always picking on? All right, let me see. This guy, hands way high here. Remember, your hands should be in a 10-inch box over the reins. All your movements should come from this area. When you start pulling up here by your chest, your elbows, your arms, you're leaning back. You're getting this, you know, you're losing your straight up and down to where you should be. And now you start leaning back. You're throwing and redistributing weight. You're confusing the horse. Let's see, we got double reins here with a tie down rope here. So that at least there's nothing by this horse's eye. I'll give him that. Let's see what else I can find wrong. Rick, why are you picking on everybody? Oh, be quiet. I'm trying. Okay. So he's got the lower, this must be the preferred style in Canada of, harnesses, of breast collars. This is pretty low. See, my breast collar connects up here to the horn and it comes straight down across the shoulder all the way down here. So the weight distribution is on a large area here versus here, the weight is right over where the shoulder kind of moves and right here. So to me, I just always thought this affected the horse movement more than the one that comes straight up. But teach his own. Not saying my way is best or right, whatever. These are called chinks. Chaps come all the way down. Chinks are short. It protects the knees. These stringy things and frills, I forgot what they call them, but anyway. Those things kind of move and it keeps flies. So if you're working out where there's bugs, flies, etc., this movement is kind of like a shoe fly. It keeps things away, like a horse's mane. Why you don't want to trim and cut it off? It moves and keeps the flies away when he shakes his little furlock. So keep the flies out of his eyes. So these are like a artificial mane or tail that keeps flies and things away and off you. Okay, that's what they're designed for. See, large room between the back of her saddle pad, the back of her saddle, to her butt. Unlike here, it's like right there. Okay? Let's see here. Not a fan of this flapping piece of leather right there that's coming through her. My guess is that she doesn't tie her latigo right, or it's a long. It's just it looks sloppy. It's something that flaps around on the horse. I don't know if this is like buckles or what's all this shit? Is this design pretty shit, or is this? Look at her. She's looking backwards. I even notice that. See, her shoulder comes way back here. Your shoulder should be flat like this guy, level and going in the same direction as your horse. Look at her shoulders, sideways looking backwards. This confused, or I'm not saying you can't look around. I'm just saying you need to understand that when you twist your hips and you look around a lot, your horse starts ignoring this, and then you can't be soft and use these movements to help guide your horse. It's kind of like nagging all the time. If you nag at your horse all the time, he stops listening to you. Where if you only use your voice when you want him to walk, stand, no, ho. If he only hears your voice when it means something, he listens better. If you're always running your mouth, he ignores you and nothing means nothing. Well, if you're always moving around, you can't be light and you have to be yanking your horse's head around with a bit. And then you're blaming a horse because he don't listen and he makes hard hands. He's got a hard head and he needs a bigger bit. And you don't even realize that you're always looking around and moving and you're slopping around a saddle. And now your horse doesn't listen to your small movements because you have desensitized them to any body language that you could have been using to communicate with him had you been quite soft and an easy load. Rick, why are you all? Be quiet, you freaking crybabies. Get out of here. Okay, so these wide things here have become somewhat popular. So a wide piece of metal or a wide piece of leather that comes across. This does distribute weight better, and it probably is better for the horse than something small. When you have something small, again, it's back to the saddle. Small, if I put any pressure on here, the pressure is on a more small and narrow area. The horse feels it more. Wide, the horse feels it less when I have to pull, and I have to pull harder to make this pressure on a larger area. Large saddle, large pad, more surface area. All right? We learning something here? Or are we just mad at me because I'm picking on people? Big ass metal chain bit with a rope halter underneath, rope here, close to the eye, chain here, loop, beckle, muddle, metal. Shit. Good grief. Everything that I complain about. Rick, why don't you like anybody? Because most people don't know shit about damn horses. Okay. Bad, bad hand. Look at this hand movement. He's not in the 10-inch box. He's twisting his shoulder. His hand is on the opposite side. If he knew rein control, he would shorten up his reins and just move his hands 3 inches. He would get the same amount of pressure by adjusting his reins in his hands. People that can't ride have these loop reins because they don't know how to rein, and then they end up pulling everything from the center. And then you get their hands way up by their chest, across their body, way out here, knocking this lady in the head when he wants to go left. Bad, bad hand. Not a lot of horsemanship in these pictures that I'm watching here. Rick, why are you picking on him? Metal, rope halter underneath this rubbing on this rope halter causing her to take metal in the mouth, pulling with one hand. But Ricky has nice chaps and okay, whatever. Whatever. Oh, look at this horse, man. I didn't have to see the guy, and I know this guy's yanking on the reins. Rick, maybe the horse is just wanting his head. No. This guy is yanking. This horse is feeling pain. You see that lip shooting out? That's pain. The horse, when their lip quivers and goes out like that, is pain. That's when they start producing saliva, and then the idiot starts saying, "Oh, foam is good." That means they're playing with the bit. They like it. Yeah, that's because you're an idiot. This is absolute pain. This horse is showing it in his face, and that lip is showing it. Ow, ow, ow. All right, so now we got to get all this shit. I'll try to fuzz this crap out. Ow, ow, ow. Oh, not only is he yanking on his freaking horse's face, what else is he doing? He didn't put his rope on top of his leg. His leg is over the rope, grinding like sand in your shoe, just grinding on a horse every step the horse takes, because his knee and his movement in the saddle is grinding this rope into his horse. Dude, you got bad horsemanship. I only seen freaking 3 seconds of you pulling on your horse's bit, causing him pain, and you put your rope under your knee. Rick, maybe it was just an accident and you're just being mean. Okay, whatever. All right, so switches here. I don't know what's going on here. Can't see well all these freaking little fuzz out things. This horse head looks kind of low. The hand is forward, so he's keeping the reins loose. Still has a stick and metal bit. Looking at the camera, but his hand just moved. His hand was here in a nice position. Now it's moving, even though the horse is still going straight. Why? Because his body's turning and he's looking this way. And because when he turns his body, this shoulder goes back. If this shoulder goes back, this hand goes back. So he's sending a signal to the horse that he's not aware of. And when the horse turns, he'll say, stupid horse, I want you to go straight. Or the horse won't turn, because he's used to his rider always doing that shit. So he's learned to ignore the reins unless it causes pain. And then he knows that he has to pay attention. And then a stupid rider will say, my horse is heavy and he needs a bigger bit and he doesn't listen. And I have to use harder hands because he doesn't listen. You have to use harder hands because you've desensitized him to being soft. People, I tell you, man, it's hard being the bearer of truth in the horse industry. Because there's just so many people. Look at all that foam coming out of this horse's mouth. Pain. Look at that. It's just dripping out of the horse's mouth. Wow. Wow. All right. So I'm not a fan of this little ride here. I know everybody will be telling me how mean I am. And these people are great guys. And everybody's wonderful. And they're doing a good cause. They are doing a good cause. I'm looking at the horsemanship. I wasn't impressed. Rick, you just want to pick on people and you think you're perfect. Shut up, you freaking crybabies. Don't come here. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T. Ransom, you're good boys.